According to the teachings of Jesus in Matthew 5, 17 to 18, the enduring relevance of the moral laws in the Ten Commandments for New Covenant believers is beyond dispute. But Joseph Prince thinks otherwise. He is of the view that the moral laws in the Ten Commandments have become obsolete for New Covenant believers, as Jesus had already fulfilled them on our behalf. Nonetheless, Matthew 5, 17 to 18 presents a major challenge for Joseph Prince. This is because Christ has stated so clearly and beyond any doubt that the moral law is still binding on New Covenant believers. So Joseph Prince has to resort to twisting the words of Jesus in Matthew 5, 17 in order to make them flow with his grace theology. The details of what I have said is found in my website, www.reverendgeorgeong.com, Volume 7, Chapter 1. The Ten Commandments are not obsolete. Matthew 5, 17 to 20. Joseph Prince teaches that when Jesus said he would fulfill the law in Matthew 5, 17, it means that he has come to fulfill all the requirements of the law on our behalf. So since Jesus has fulfilled the law on our behalf, including the moral law in the Ten Commandments, we don't have to fulfill them anymore, as all the moral laws are no longer relevant for New Covenant believers. Joseph Prince said, Jesus came to fulfill all the requirements of the law on our behalf. Did Jesus say that? No, he didn't. Jesus said, I have not come to abolish them, but to fulfill them. But Jesus didn't say he came to fulfill all the requirements of the law on our behalf, as Joseph Prince had stated. Where did Joseph Prince get those three words, on our behalf, from? From the scriptures? No, he got it from his own imagination. Appallingly, Joseph Prince added three words, on our behalf, into the mouth of Jesus and the Word of God in Matthew 5, 17. He doesn't care if he added words into the mouth of Jesus and the Word of God, which he did. He doesn't care two hoots about the warning in Revelation 22, 18 to 19 that was given by Jesus himself, that anyone who adds or subtracts from the Word of God, his eternal inheritance would be at stake. Although the warning is specifically sounded for the book of Revelation, I believe it is also a stern warning from Jesus never to commit the same scandalous act of adding or subtracting from the other parts of his holy word. Adding or subtracting from the word of God is to alter the very message of the sovereign God, and it is an abominable act for anyone to engage in. And yet, this is what Joseph Prince did. In his books and sermons, Joseph Prince has always been teaching that when Christ died on the cross to institute the new covenant of grace, he has fulfilled the law. And hence, the moral laws in the Ten Commandments have been made obsolete. But Jesus didn't say in Matthew 5, 17, that the moral laws have become obsolete. And yet, Joseph Prince contradicted the words of Jesus when he said the Ten Commandments have been made obsolete. Jesus repeated his message that he has not come to abolish the law in Matthew 5, 17 twice to make sure that no one misses it. Any person with average intelligence will get the message loud and clear. Yet, Joseph Prince doesn't seem to get it. No, it is not his intelligence that is at fault. It is because he values his grace theology more than the words of Jesus. He places a higher priority on his grace doctrine, more than even the teachings of Jesus, that he is determined to guard it at all costs, even at the expense of twisting the very words of Jesus. Joseph Prince teaches that just as Jesus cried out, "Finished," at his death on the cross. The law, including the moral laws in the Ten Commandments, were also finished and came to an end. But if one were to look at Matthew 5, 17 to 18, tell me, did Jesus mention anything about his death on the cross at all? Absolutely not. Joseph Prince has again daringly added his words to the Word of God. To be exact, Joseph Prince added these words: the law was perfectly fulfilled at the cross when he cried out, "Finished." These are the words he added to the Word of God. Both Matthew 5:17 and John 19:30 that Joseph Prince listed in his quote could not support such a connection between the cross and the law. In the phrase, "the law was perfectly fulfilled at the cross when he cried out, 'Finish.'" Such a connection between the cross and the law, in his said phrase, that it was the cross which ended the moral law, is a concoction of his own imagination. Christ's death on the cross was never used as the reference point for the fulfilling of the law as it is falsely postured by Joseph Prince. Rather, the reference points that Christ used are far beyond after his death on the cross. When he specified that the law would be relevant at least until heaven and earth disappear and everything is accomplished in Matthew 5:18. For anyone reading Matthew 5:17-20, one would be clear that first, the law has not been abolished or made obsolete, verse 17. Second, the law is going to be with us for a long time to come, until heaven and earth pass away, verse 18. And third, the law is to be practiced or obeyed by every new covenant believer, verses 19-20. Jesus has made it as clear as he could in Matthew 5:17-20 about the continuing relevance of the law that even a 12-year-old kid could comprehend. Yet, Joseph Prince dares to twist the passage to repudiate the message of Jesus in order to make it conform to his grace doctrine. Joseph Prince seems unable to understand about the difference between Christ's work on the cross for our salvation that is finished and the law, which the Lord Jesus said is not yet finished, because everything has not been accomplished yet and heaven and earth have not passed away yet in Matthew 5:18. Joseph Prince is terribly mixed up in his theology, mixing up the cross which has been finished and the moral laws which have remained in force till today. It doesn't mean just because Jesus is finished with the cross, he is also finished with the moral laws in the Ten Commandments. Matthew 5:18 informs us that well beyond Christ's death on the cross, these moral laws will still be permanent and relevant until when? Until everything is accomplished and until heaven and earth, which refers to the end of this age, disappear or pass away. Has everything been accomplished yet? Certainly not. The everything must certainly include every prophecy that is still unfulfilled. So, has everything, including every unfulfilled prophecy, been accomplished yet? Of course not. Have heaven and earth pass away yet? Definitely not. While heaven and earth are still with us, Jesus says nothing in the law shall pass away. This means that heaven and earth shall not pass away until every minute detail of the law shall be absolutely and entirely fulfilled. And the law will hold and stand until heaven and earth pass away, and not until the death of Christ on the cross, as Joseph Prince falsely teaches. In the next video, I'm going to highlight the seriousness about not recognizing that the law still exists today in Matthew 5:19-20, and that the consequences of not obeying the law better than the Pharisees did is to have the kingdom of heaven shut right in our face. Finally, you need to be aware of the teaching that the moral law, which is now obsolete by virtue of grace, is the cornerstone of Joseph Prince's grace doctrine. Yet, it is this core doctrine of Joseph Prince that directly contradicts the teachings of Jesus in Matthew 5, 17 to 20. Imagine the complete disparity. Joseph Prince says the moral law is now obsolete, but Jesus says the moral law is here to stay until heaven and earth pass away. No true teacher of the word would dare to teach something that is diametrically opposed to that of Jesus. So how can Joseph Prince, who teaches against Jesus openly, ever claim that he is a true teacher of the word? How people can still believe that Joseph Prince is a Christ-centered preacher when he dares to alter the message of God the Son in broad daylight, defies every logic and common sense. Such deplorable behavior can never come from a true teacher of God's word, but it can only come from a wolf in sheep's skin who has come to teach a different Jesus from that of the Bible.